For experiment one, we'll be measuring the angle using potentiometer. As you know, potentiometer is a variable resistance, and as you can see, this is your potentiometer, this is your motor, this is your tachometer, this is your encoder, and this is your arm, which would trigger all the motors and tachometers, right? So for getting the angle using potentiometer, we'll be using voltage drop across the potentiometer. So if there is a bigger angle, the potential drop will be higher, and you will be getting a different value. So the way you record the angle using a potentiometer is, since the potentiometer is nothing but a varying resistance, and when the resistance changes, you can calculate the angle by using this formula. So you know that if angle increases, the potential drop across the potentiometer increases. So you can take a proportionality constant, and you can name it K part, and you can see that K part is equal to theta L by V part. Once you find the K part, you can find any value of theta if you have the voltage value, right? So for this experiment, we'll be putting the arm at 0 degrees, and we'll run the experiment. So as you can see, at zero it's at -0.08 or something, right? So this would be your offset, and when we turn it to 45 degrees or -45 degrees, we'll be removing this voltage offset from the voltage we get, right? So instead of 90 degrees, we'll be using -45 and +45 because we have markings for 45 and -45. So as you can see, I put it at approximately 45 degrees, and here you can see that the voltage is -1.37 volts, and when I change it to 45, the voltage changes to 1.47 to 49 volts, and if we use the offset, it would be almost the same. And so now we have a voltage value at -45, we have a voltage value at 0, and we have a voltage value at 45, right? So we can get the angle. So if you see here, you have 45 degrees voltage, you have 0 degrees voltage, and you have 45 plus 45 degrees voltage, right? So now you can get the so you know that this range is 90 degrees. So for 90 degrees, you know the voltage drop, because you know the voltage for -45 and +45. So you can just get -45, and if the voltage drop across is V45, it's just minus V45 minus of minus V -45, right? So this is the full range of voltage difference. So you can have this one, and you can have one range as 0 to 45 degrees, and one range as -45 degrees to 0 degrees. So you'll get 3 K parts using all these, and once you take the average of all these, you can get the K potentiometer for this specific potentiometer, right? And you can also plot all these values to get the linear to see the linear trend of this, and the slope of it would be your potential K part, right? Okay.